April 14th, 2020, early in the morning, Deadside releases on the Steam store. Word quickly spreads about this game and players start to flood in. Community servers are opened and players are having their first gunfights with Makarovs and double barrel shotguns. Compared to a lot of other open world survival games, Deadside has a lot more PvP, so naturally players begin to get more competitive. And when there is competition, there are some people out there that will do anything to get an advantage. Word spreads quickly of a money duplication glitch, but in reality, it was much more severe. Players could take advantage of some server coding bugs by tricking the server into giving them items when they log back in, that in reality, they had just thrown those exact items onto the floor, which were of course still there. This was quickly patched out about a week or so after release, however, the damage was already done. Players now knew that this game could be broken. And with this exploit gone, they would go looking for new ones. Others would go down a darker path. With this game getting a lot of attention, it would also attract people looking to make some money with their skills. Deadside runs in Unreal Engine 4, so it didn't take coders long with previous experience with the engine to begin making cheats. Let's take a step back. The team behind Deadside is Bad Pixel. There isn't much information about them on the internet, but from what I can tell, there are at least three main developers working on the game in the beginning. Most people in the community will tell you that there are around 5 developers, and to this day, I'm pretty confident that the team has less than 10 people. For them, Deadside is a huge passion project, and they're taking on not only a big challenge, but a big risk making this game. Exploits and cheats are universal problems, and considering how small their team is, they just simply lack the resources to deal with it like other larger game producers. The reality of it is that this game either exists with some issues, or it just doesn't exist at all. A few days after the duplication exploit was patched, there are still some players with lots of money and gear. But the game is still new and everyone is having fun, and since the players with a lot of gear don't really understand how to use it yet, they will often die to fresh spawns. Then people start to notice some odd things. Players seem to be almost godlike with their skills. Their map knowledge is amazing and their aim and recoil control is perfect. While players with high skill levels are normal in other games like this, Deadside has only been out for a number of days. It doesn't take long for more red flags to pop up. Players will die through bushes every now and then. Some people get sniped from over 300 meters away, despite there being no actual magnified scopes in the game yet. The personalities of these players are odd as well. Some are just really cocky, while others are full-blown toxic. Things only got worse from there. Players would be killed through bushes and water without problem. Players would be killed over absurd distances from full auto fire. There are even some accounts of players having infinite health and video evidence of land speed records being broken. Considering that Deadside launched with no anti-cheat software at all, it was pretty clear what was happening. On April 30th, 16 days after release, Easy Anti-Cheat was integrated into the game. This change instantly helped. Cheaters using blatant software were banned, and while it didn't solve the issue totally, just having more risk involved reduced the problem a lot. And for the most part, after this update, the game was a lot more playable overall. During this time, after that update, this is when the major bits of the community would start to solidify. Private servers were set up and communities were made, and the players started to figure out what kinds of servers they prefer. We start to see some of the focus shift from the official servers, which players first joined when they started playing, to the community ones. Community servers have community admins, which would deal with toxicity and cheaters, unlike the official servers, which had none. These servers could also implement rules to combat issues like safe zone camping or base camping, which the game offered no solutions to. These community servers and admins provided the structure needed for healthy communities to start forming. During this time, we see the global player count drop due to players losing interest, which is pretty typical for games after release, but because of the core communities, the player base would stick around. Let's skip over some time to the present day. By doing this, we skip over some major exploits, which I will mention later, but for now, let's talk about what the community is facing in present day. The reason I told you about the early days of this game, about the cheaters and the early exploits, is because I'm putting you in the perspective of a long-time core player. As one of these players, you know about these issues, and you trust the community admins to take care of them. So then, it's in the player's best interest that the admins have the tools to deal with these issues, right? Well, that's where we get into the main point of this video. Admins, as of right now, just don't have the tools to deal with cheaters or exploiters. All admins can do to catch cheaters is see who is online, they can see the kill logs, and they can teleport. They can't spectate players, they can't fly, they can't see player locations, any of that stuff. Admins totally depend on the player base in their server to send them clips of their perspective in order for them to do anything. And because of this, it's pretty easy for a good cheater or a sneaky exploiter to totally fly under the radar. Game cheats are also stored on USB sticks and injected into the computer's memory, so even if an admin looked through somebody's computer, they would still never find any evidence of cheating. We all know there will always be cheaters and exploiters in this game, as they are in every game, and unless admins get the tools to deal with it, they will always be an issue. Sure, the exploits will get patched and cheaters will have to constantly fight easy anti-cheat to keep going, but that doesn't mean they still won't pop up and cause problems. And this isn't even considering the rules that admins put in place to prevent safe zone camping or enforce their squad limits. It seems obvious that one of the most important features that this game needs right now is some better admin tools similar to what games like Rust and DayZ have. However, this all depends on one thing. Trust. Does Bad Pixel trust the server community admins enough to spend their limited time making these tools? Unfortunately, I can see why they wouldn't, because the more tools you give admins, the more ways they can abuse them. Admin abuse might not seem like a complicated issue at first. Generally, it's pretty obvious when an admin is a toxic person, banning people for no reason, or just using their admin abilities to spawn in gear and get an advantage in PvP. The community won't play on servers with admins like that. It's an issue that just sorts itself out. In reality though, admins can abuse their power to gain other things than just an advantage in PvP. One really good motivation to do so is money. It costs admins a decent amount of money to run a 50-slot server, and while admins will usually just pay it themselves or through donations through the community, there have been times where admins try to make profit. They can try and sell in-game items that are spawned in through the admin menu for real money, and while if you're caught doing this, your server will be blacklisted, I'm sure that doesn't stop some under-the-table sneaky deals, unfortunately. But it gets even worse if you consider the possibility of server admins working with cheat sellers. In theory, a cheat provider could sell a server admin a list of every person they have sold Deadside cheats to, so that the server admin could then ban them from their server and any other servers that they work with. The cheat provider would benefit from this since the players who are now banned might come back to buy other things like a new account, or an IP spoofer, or maybe even just more cheats to use on a new account of their own. Either way, a cheat provider doesn't benefit at all from the cheaters actually playing or using their cheats, since they only make money from the sale. So why wouldn't they just sell a list of their customers for a bit of extra cash on the side? Now it is different if the cheats are sold on a subscription-based service, but cheat sellers getting involved with any active server admins or becoming an admin of an active server themselves is pretty much a nightmare scenario. So considering all that, I can understand why Bad Pixel would be hesitant to give admins more tools. These are the issues with the tools that are already in game, and with the tools I'm talking about potentially adding, you would basically give the admins the ability to cheat on their own server without actually using any cheat software. Seeing players through walls is important to catch cheaters using wall hacks, but it also allows the admin the ability to use it in their own PvP as well. The ability to spectate players is also very important for catching people using aimbot, but it also gives admins tons of information about the players that they otherwise wouldn't have, like their location, their base location, or even the location of their base crates and what's in them as well. The ability for admins to fly or free cam also opens up all of the same issues. Unfortunately, some decisions that the team made recently even suggest that they don't trust server admins with the tools they already have. They recently removed the ability of admins to spawn in dog tags, and they have also never given them the ability to spawn in keys or skinned weapons, as well as the sunglasses items or the skinned armor. Now this could be due to the fact that the Steam terminal is coming in the future, and those items either won't exist in the future or shouldn't ever be spawned in for balance reasons, but I'm willing to bet at least part of that decision for not letting admins spawn in those items is so they don't abuse them for money or their own use. But, as I mentioned earlier, exploiters and cheaters are never going away. Even with the best top-of-the-line anti-cheat, there are still going to be cheaters, and as development of the game goes on, new exploits will pop up. This is how I see it. Bad Pixel can either spend some time now making these admin tools, or they can spend a lot more time in the future dealing with new exploits and cheaters as they pop up instead of working on the game. Either way, they're going to have to spend some time dealing with these issues, so it just makes sense to go with a long-term solution that would benefit the community the most. If you agree, please like the video. It'll show the team that the community really does want these tools, and it would also really help the channel, which I appreciate. That's all I have for now. Thanks for watching.